Head Start Sunday, and now we're getting ready to go into something else. And we just sit around here like it's nothing. Brothers and sisters, you got to say something. Speak to the Father. We don't want to hurt people. We want to stop them from doing some things. But if they don't want to stop, they're not going to stop no matter what we say or do. If the Father spoke down and said, if you diligently obey me, and they said, we ain't doing that. That's what they told the Father. They didn't really just put them to him like that, but when you speak a word, he hears your words. Uh-huh. He knows your thoughts and the intents of your thoughts. Uh-huh. He knows everything about you. And you speak negativity into his ear, but you still want to bless him. Uh-huh. Say that a little bit louder, brother. We need it. And Paul said, y'all got a man sitting in y'all sanctuary who done got with his daddy's bride, and y'all ain't doing nothing about it. Mm-hmm. I hope nobody in here, anybody in here waiting for Christmas?
Yeah, hallelujah.
That's what I'm waiting for. I got what I call the two biggest, baddest feasts on the block. Pesach and Sukkot.
Yeah.
Now everything in between, I love it. But them two on the ends? Because one represents sacrifice and one represents ingathering. Yeah, I thank him for the sacrifice and I'm waiting to be ingathered. Come on, somebody. Ezra. You know, one people don't like to talk about Ezra too much because Ezra was a powerful preacher. Him and Nehemiah worked together. They call him Nehemiah, but his true name is Nehemiah. They work together, building the wall back to Jerusalem.
Yeah.
And they were under threats. Mm-hmm. And guess what? He told him, he said, I tell you what y'all do. Hold a brick in one hand and your sword in the other.
Yep. That's what he said.
Don't be scared. Let's build this thing. Mm-hmm. So I got, look. I got my sword in this hand right here.
Uh-huh.
And I work with you on this one.
But
guess what? I ain't giving up. I got to build this wall.
Yes,
I got children to protect. I got grandchildren and great-grandchildren. I want them to be saved.
Hallelujah.
I don't want, who knows who Molech is? Molech and Milcom, that's the same one. They just call him by different names.
Yeah.
Who knows who that is? Who is that? That's the fire god. Mm-hmm. That's the one they offered their children to.
Uh-huh.
But guess what? Just like that lady was having her little baby girl do all that gyrating and stuff in front of them and cheering her on, they're preparing that child for Milcom. To be fueled in hell's fire. That's not a joke. That's not a laughing matter. That's sad.
Yeah.
That you brought a child in this world to send him to hell. I'm talking about you love your baby. Shut up. I forgot where I said I was going. Ezra chapter 7, verse number 23. Let's go over there. Whatever is commanded by the Eli of heaven, let it be diligently done. Whatever is commanded by the Almighty in heaven, let it be diligently done. For the house of the Almighty Yah, for why should there be wrath against the kingdom of men and his sons? Why should you suffer wrath? When he's telling you what to do, you ought to diligently do it. Why would you let wrath come upon you? It's one thing to be angry. But when wrath come, there ain't no mercy. There ain't no pity in wrath. When the Father got upset, when he told his man, he said, go over there and put them under the ban, which means kill everything. The Father was done with him. He said, I want everything to die. I don't want the animals. I don't want nothing. Kill them all. And they come back with goats and sheep. And women, and Agag, the king.
Yeah.
And Samuel said, did you do the Father told you to do? Oh, yeah, I did. Mm-hmm. But the people said, they wanted the sheep and the goats to offer to Almighty God. Did he ask you for that? Did he ask you for an offering?
No, sir.
Obedience is better than no sacrificing.
Yeah.
I told you, don't bring nobody back. Give me your sword. Let me go check Agag over here. And Shimei took that sword and put Agag to sleep.
In pieces.
In pieces.
Yes, sir, in pieces.
He did what the father told that man to do. I'm going to tell you like this. I don't want nobody taking my place.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
I'm going to stand where he put me until he comes back through the clouds of the air.
Yeah.
Are y'all hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Praise his Kodesh name.
Yeah.
Proverbs chapter 11. How many of y'all know how to get favor? Another word, grace. Another word, influence. How do you know how to get it? Well, getting up, you just better see something in Proverbs going to tell you who's going to get it. Look at verse number 27. He that what? Diligently seeks good obtains favor. But he that seeks mischief, it will come to him. If you seek mischief, you're going to get it. You're going to get what you're looking for. Hallelujah. When you came here this morning, what were you looking for? I didn't come here looking for a sandwich. I didn't come here looking for blueberry pancakes. I got them. But it was brought. And I thank the one who brought it. But I didn't come here looking for that. I came here looking for two things. One, I came here looking for the fellowship of my brothers and my sisters. If they didn't bring pancakes, if they didn't bring rice and milk toast, if they didn't bring none of that, I was glad to see them.
Yes,
when Brother Gavin walked in the day, I was glad to see him. Brother Ben and his wife were missing for a couple of weeks, I was glad to see him. I was glad. I'm overjoyed.
Yes, sir.
I'm glad to see Sister Pete. I'll be glad to see y'all.
Yes,
and the second thing I came here for was get myself full of the word.
Yes, yeah.
I want a double portion.
Yes, indeed. Yes.
Hallelujah. Just because I'm teaching don't mean I'm not eating.
Uh-huh.
I'm not the kind of cook who cooks and don't taste the food. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Most of the time when I get through cooking, I don't need to eat.
Uh-huh.
I done tasted myself full. I said, what you going to do with it? I'm going to put it in the refrigerator until tomorrow. I'll eat it tomorrow.
Hallelujah.
Now, I'll say that if certain people wasn't at the house. But when certain people at the house, I'm going to eat it then because it might not be there tomorrow. I ain't going to call no names. Jeremiah 12. One thing about it though, he cooked. And whenever I find something, he didn't cook, and he might be trying to save it till tomorrow. My turn. Jeremiah 12, verse number 16. And it will be if they will diligently learn the ways of my people. In other words, if you come from some congregation to this congregation,
uh-huh.
you need to learn what y'all people are doing here.
Yes, indeed.
I don't want to know what you did over there. Because
yeah.
if you wanted that over there, you would have stayed over there.
Uh-huh.
But since the Father led you to come here, you need to learn the ways of his people right here. In other words, to make oaths by my name,
mm-hmm.
as Almighty Yah live, as they taught my people to swear by Baal, Baal. They shall be established in the midst of my people, but if they do not obey, I will pluck them up.
Woo.
I will pluck them up and destroy that whole nation. So you over here teaching people how to worship Baal,
mm-hmm.
I'm over here teaching people how to worship Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. So when you come here, I'm going to declare to you, Almighty Yah, from the beginning, Bereshit, all the way to Revelation, and I'm going to break it all down. I'm going to bring some Sefer stuff in there so you can understand. They got more than that for you to understand. I want you to understand all of this. And it takes time for that.
Yes, indeed.
I hate to tell you, but you ain't going to become a certified, bona fide, justified preacher overnight. You got to get something under your belt. The Father said, I got to get you, I got to establish you, I got to settle you, I got to get you prepared to go out there and stand before people. Why? Because you'll get the big head because you are nothing but a novice.
Mm-hmm.
And novice are puffed up easily with a little bit of knowledge. So you can get knowledge, but knowledge can be, what they call that stuff, dynamite. In the wrong hands.
Yes, sir.
With a short fuse. And you'll cause somebody to lose their soul by what you feel rather than what you know. When I first started off in the ministry, I messed a lot of folks up. See, I'm confessing. I confessed already. I'm just bringing y'all up to snuff. Yeah, I messed a lot of people up because I was just mean. If you didn't get the truth, I wanted to take my sword and cut your neck and push the truth down in there. I was the one sitting in people's church and the man said something wrong in teaching. I said, excuse me. That's not right. Let's look in the scripture. And the lady said, do you know who you're talking to? I said, yeah, him. Yeah. I ain't going to those places playing around. I'm still not playing around. I'm just a little bit more at ease. Thank you, my brother. That's a better word. You have to refine me. I was uncut. I was rough.
Thank you.
He said, you hurting people. You making people mad at you. You making enemies instead of friends. And I used to wonder, why everybody running when I come? Jeremiah 17.
Hallelujah.
Now, people asked me about the Sabbath. And I told them that it was before Shemot. It lasted all through scriptures. The Messiah kept it.
Yes,
sir. Shaul kept it. Mm-hmm. I didn't see nowhere in scripture that it ever ceased.
Uh-huh.
Now, if somebody can show me that, I'm still going to keep this habit.
Yeah.
I'm being honest with y'all. Mm-hmm. I can't go back to Sunday.
No.
Yes,
I know about that.
That's right.
So if the Father tells me I can pick any day I want, I might pick Monday. Just as good as Sunday. A man picked that one. I'll just pick another one. But I'll just keep the Sabbath. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to keep the Sabbath anyway.
Hallelujah.
If he tell me I can eat anything I want to eat, I'm not going back to crab, crawfish, neither shrimp.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going, huh? I ain't going back to that either. Keep your hog. I feel too good without it.
Yes, indeed, sir. Hallelujah.
Jeremiah chapter 17, verse number 24. That's Jeremiah 17, 24. And it will be, he said, it will be, if you diligently obey me, declares Almighty Yah, to bring in no burdens through the gates of this city on the Sabbath day, and set apart the Sabbath day, that means put it on the side, no, don't do on the Sabbath what you did on them other days, don't do any work in the Sabbath. 25, then kings and heads sitting on the thrones of David will enter into the city, into the gate.